Hey, Hugh, thanks for coming in and joining us.
Hey, thanks.
Appreciate you spending some time. Have a seat. We'll go through our prototype here. So we're beginning a project here that is, I guess, a bit of an event management app. Think about it like to-dos, events, that kind of thing. I'm curious to get your feedback on the general flow of the app, but I'm also curious to get your feedback on some very specific things. So for instance, in taking a look at, you can see here that we have a screen where we can create new events. But I'm kind of curious to understand from the home screen, when you first come into the app, do you see something that stands out for you that would draw you to go ahead and create a new event?
Sure, so there's a big red plus there, and it's red, and so I'm looking at it, and that matches a lot of other design elements on Android. That's like a material design thing that I'm really familiar with in a whole bunch of other places. So I would, if I was at this screen, mm-hmm. I would hit that plus and expect to create an event. I'm not sure whether that would necessarily create an event right here where it shows the date as the 25th, or whether that would create an event that I would still have to fill in the date, but that's what I would expect.
Yeah, you know, you bring up a great point, right? Sensible defaults in the creation screen would make a lot of sense for us. In that case, like inserting the date, because we've come from a specific event, specific screen here that lists the date.
Like on this screen, where it looks like this is a day view.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and so here the plus, I would definitely expect it to create that default.
Yeah, so the pattern there is a floating action button. And we see that pattern actually repeat itself a little bit through the app here. One question for you, the floating action button tends to move around a little bit within the UI though. Would you consider that to be a jarring part of the experience, or do you feel that you understand the action of the button irregardless of where it's positioned in the screen?
So I see it in three places here, here and here, which are basically the same.
Yeah.
There's no real difference there, and here at the bottom. And it's nice to get it out of the way here. I think that's sort of where I expect it. Based on using a bunch of other apps.
Mm-hmm.
And likewise, here, presumably this screen is going to move up and down and it will stay in this interface, the border between the header and the actual list of events.
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense to me.
Yeah, we're contemplating implementing some really nice animations as you scroll through this screen. So it's possible that the fab might grow and shrink. Mm-hmm. It might disappear as you scroll up through the list, but we want to keep context in the tab headers as we progress through the views, because it's important that you maintain that information, right? That you be able to swap between the week and the month very quickly. Now, in looking at the fab on this particular page, on the week page, one of the things we've seen in the past is that the fab can get in the way of some of the content.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel that that's really a problem for us here?
I feel like right now where it is at the bottom right, you know, it's going to cover something.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't cover that much.
Mostly avatars in this screen right now.
Yeah. Also, given how many items are being displayed and the fact that the user is going to have to scroll through but can see roughly three or four at a time anyway,
mm-hmm.
it seems to make sense. It could not exist at all, but that doesn't seem like that would be better.
Okay. So given that this is an event / to-do management app, one of the things that we really want to make sure that users can do is actually check off and complete those tasks. Do you see a clear way to do that within these screens?
I don't see anything that actually says that this is like to-dos at all. Like all of this looks like calendar and event stuff to me.
Interesting.
Everything here has a time. It looks like it all has places as well.
Mm-hmm.
The idea of there being like, there's no checkbox, there's no indication that these are things that could be accomplished as another to-do list. So I don't see that.
Interesting. And so if I were to direct you over here to these checkboxes
and these UI
elements, do you feel that that's, obviously when you walk through the screens here, that was a miss, right?
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel that we can evolve that to make that a little bit more prominent, make that functionality stand out just a bit more? It's a core part of the experience that we want here,
mm-hmm.
And so we need to do a better job of showcasing that feature.
I'm not sure that the circular checkbox would be as good as a square checkbox. Usually when we check off things in most applications, there's mm-hmm. An empty square that gets checked as opposed to like a gray circle that changes color and has that mm-hmm. In there. I think it's also a little bit deceptive how this is displayed, very much as sort of calendar events that have locations and times, which to-do lists certainly can have locations and times,
mm-hmm.
but the thing to do is often the by far the most relevant rather than the time.
Mm-hmm.
And so I wouldn't normally go through my calendar and check off the events that I actually went to. Whereas with a to-do list manager, having the check be more prominent than the time would make sense.
Interesting. So certainly it sounds to me like you feel that the affordance needs to be stronger. But there's also a question about whether or not we're actually managing to-dos versus calendar events here. So perhaps the to-do aspect of the app needs to stand out a bit more.
Right. So this here, you know, we have the exact same things. And this very much looks like a calendar. There's no way of checking something off. And
absolutely.
This, we can check it off. What does that do? Does that remove it from our calendar? I don't know.
Yeah, that's it. You know, I think that's a great question to ask is what would you expect to happen when you did check something off? Would you expect it to disappear from your calendar? Would you expect there to be an animation associated with that? Would you want to see it in place?
Yeah, if I'm using some kind of a to-do list manager, I think I do want something to happen when I check it off. And that probably means striking it out in case it was an accidental check. I don't want it just to disappear immediately.
Yeah, good feedback.
Potentially, it could move away and be left with an undo. But in this case, where these obviously are calendar-ish things, I don't want them removed from my calendar. I might want to go back and see them.
Absolutely. I think maintaining some historical context here is really important to actually managing the set of events that are happening here. Let me ask you one more question. In terms of gesture support for this screen, how would you expect a user to interact with this to check something as completed? Would you expect a tap, a swipe?
With this screen, I would expect a tap to bring up a screen that has more detailed information. So something like this with
like a detailed view.
So tap might bring it up to edit it.
Uh-huh.
I wouldn't expect it to check it off unless the tap was on basically the check mark, which is why it might be a good idea to have it larger. This is a very small target area.
Yeah, we really want to make sure that we have a 40 dip tap target. You know, that making sure that we have 40 device independent pixels is a valuable part of touch responsiveness. Making sure that we have enough room for the finger on the screen.
I'm not totally sure what a swipe left or right might do. It's possible that you could train users to do that, but it's not super intuitive what the objective would actually be. Swiping up or down definitely should move through the list, and we can see things that are farther down.
So one of the things you also mentioned was that there was some consistency in the experience here. One thing, though, is that we're only allowing you to manage apps from the day view. Would you expect to want to be able to manage those events from your home screen as well, or is that more of like a heads-up display?
You mean that here you can check them off and here you can't?
That's correct.
If to-do list management is really a top-level objective, then probably doing that from the home screen is really important. I mean, one of the things about to-do lists is people just won't use them if it takes a long time to do things. So taking an extra tap to get through to a day view screen to manage the to-do list might keep people from interacting with it.
Yeah, that does seem inefficient.
But again, here, if I tapped on any of these items, I would normally expect to be taken to an edit rather than be able to complete. Also, it's weird here that you can edit everything about this potential item except whether it's been accomplished or not. So here you have to actually be in this screen and see the list to check items off if that's possible. Whereas here, you can edit everything else, but not that.
Mm-hmm. There isn't even a notion of delete yet here either, right?
Right.
Where would you expect to see delete? Would you expect to see that here with completion, here in the edit UI?
I would definitely expect it to be in the edit UI someplace, because when everything else fails, people are probably going to go look for it there. It also potentially is reasonable for a swipe gesture to move this off and delete it.
Interesting. So maybe swipe one way to complete, swipe another way to delete.
That is a method of interaction that, for instance, gets used on inbox, and so I think it's pretty familiar to a lot of users.
Yeah, that particular swipe affordance is quite popular in inbox as well, yeah. Great. Well, I really appreciate you coming out and giving us a little bit of feedback on the app. You've definitely caught some glaring issues for us. We definitely need to iterate here a little bit more, but I would really appreciate getting more feedback when we have iterated and improved based on the feedback you've given. Would you be willing to give us more feedback in the future?
Yeah, absolutely.
Great. Thank you very much.